Well, guys, and welcome back to another episode of War Thunder. Today I'm playing the Machi C-205 Series 3 again. It's one of my favorite aircrafts. This is still on the previous patch before the French forces have been introduced. I must say that I haven't played a lot of War Thunder lately, as there's still people, you know, grinding through the French tech tree, and to be honest, I'm really interested in the French aircraft, but I'm not very interested in playing in arcade, really. I played a few games in arcade, I unlocked a few planes, but the waiting time for realistic battles is just freaking insane, and you just lose the will to continue. So yeah, this aircraft, this is a beauty to fly, really. It's somehow maneuverable, turns to some point, there's a really good climb rate, there's a really good firepower, and it should be used mainly on boom and zoom attacks, as I normally do. Now, as you can see, all my team is climbing, which is a really good thing, as you know, normally when people climb, it's when you achieve victories. Yeah. I've tried to play the Japanese, but I can't really see which plane I want to fly, really. I want to make a video on a Japanese aircraft, but I really don't know, because I don't know. Looks like the Japanese planes lost all their magic to me. I used to love flying those things, but right now, I don't feel like it, really. It's not the first time that I've tried to fly Japanese aircraft, but the teams, oh my god, they're terrible, really. I really don't know what to say. And I think that you can have that as another excuse not to fly Japanese, really, as they're kinda scraping the bottom of the barrel, although they shouldn't, because they have really good machines. So now I'm at 2,900 meters. My engine is starting to cook up a little bit. I put my nose a little bit down and reduce throttle, of course. I don't want to cook this aircraft engine. When I was flying this aircraft, it's already fully spaded, so it's like maximum performance. You'll have no issues whatsoever. Because normally some planes do suffer from the stock syndrome. And this plane actually was really pleasant since day one. Now there's a B-61 way above me, and I'm thinking to myself, what the hell am I going to get that guy? Really not. I'm just going to avoid him. I don't know if he didn't see me or just thought that it was a better idea to engage two other fighters besides me, but that's what he does. He goes after that 109, and I'm just going to follow him now and wait for him to make a mistake, really. Behind me, there's a few Allied fighters that are really still climbing when they should be really up here already. Especially Spitfires, as they can have a lot of advantage at altitude. Yeah, they are very difficult planes to counter, really. Now that B-61 is starting to do a shallow dive on the 109. As usual, I'm just observing, see what's going to happen. There's a Spitfire to my right, I'm going to ignore him as he's pretty far away from me. I'm just going to focus on the B-61. So now they were fighting out of bounds, and the B-61 got the advantage to run away from the 109, but that didn't really help him, as now I'm on his 6. Remember, the P-61 is a very dangerous aircraft, even if you get on it six, as that's that stupid 360 degrees turret, and will literally kill you in a small burst, as the American 50s really don't. They're not forgiving. They're all trying to get a handle on them, as you can see. Few hits, damaged engine, there goes his still control, and he's really going down, or was. He managed to get control again, and I put a few shots into the cockpit and literally kill everyone. After that engagement, that's going to be my only kill, really, as things will develop. As the Americans know, the Allies will literally get shoot up at altitude by the German team, really, and they'll start making mistakes of, you know, start diving, and that will cost them. Well, on the final part, I chased a few Spitfires. I almost got this Spitfire right here, but he starts to maneuver and there's no way in hell that I'm going to hit him, and that's actually a pretty dangerous maneuver, as I could have got myself killed there. As the Spitfire is already on my 6 and catching up to me, but no problems. The P-47 just did a head-on with it and turned into shreds. Now those two teammates are trying to kill the already dead enemy aircraft, and for the statistics you can see that everyone's already dead, and this is the end of the match. Yeah, so I hope you guys have enjoyed this very, very small episode. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.